to Carter Allen's Decibel Diaries on 100.7 WZLX.
Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, Fooled Again, I Don't Like It. Live on stage in Germany, November 1977, the studio original featured on Tom Petty's first album. I'm Carter Allen, and I'm talking to record label promo man Jon Scott about his cool book, Tom Petty and Me. Back in 1988, when I was the music director at WBCN, I got a fax in the office from Tom Petty promoting the new Traveling Wilburys album. So, assuming it was him, I faxed him back, because the number, of course, was on there. And lo and behold, after all these years, my note to Tom ended up reprinted in Jon Scott's new book. I asked Jon about Petty and the pre-scanning device that was our tool of the trade in the 80s. You said that you turned Tom Petty onto the fax machine and he went crazy and he started promoting the Traveling Wilburys record with it, just faxing everybody.
Well, at first we were just faxing each other, and I noticed that everyone would come back to me. It was funnier than the last one. And he was just, you know, his southern sense of humor would come out on these fax machines. And then I started thinking, well, Tom, would you fax every station I just give you, like 100? He said, sure. And so every fax he sent to the radio stations were all different. And all of a sudden, he started getting faxes back, like from you guys. When he got a fax back from you guys, he called me. He said, I can't believe this.
Hey,
a radio station just faxed me back.
Yeah. You get Tom Petty's inside number, you're going to use it.
Yeah. And the people, some people would call and go, hey, I just got a fax from Charlie T. Wilbury. Is that Tom Petty, really? I said, there. His number's at the top of the page. There's faxing back. And so that's what started happening. So he just breezed through 100 faxes, and it took him a few days. But we called it the Traveling Wilburys fax promotion. Matter of fact, I don't know of any other artist that sent out faxes, to be quite honest with you. They might have, but
no. In these days, the kids don't even know what a fax machine is.
I don't have one. Do you?
Not anymore.
Carter Allen's Decibel Diaries on 100.7 WZLX.
Well, it's all right, riding around in the breeze. Well, it's all right, if you live the life you please. Well, it's all right, doing the best you can. Well, it's all right, as long as you lend a hand.
You can sit around and wait for the phone to ring, waiting for someone to tell you everything. Sit around and wonder what tomorrow will bring. Maybe a diamond ring.
Well, it's all right, even if they say you're wrong. Well, it's all right, sometimes you gotta be strong. Well, it's all right, as long as you got somewhere to lay.
Somewhere down the road away, you'll think of me and wonder where I am these days. Maybe somewhere down the road when somebody plays purple haze.
Well, it's all right, even when push comes to shove. Well, it's all right, if you got someone to love. Well, it's
I'm just glad to be here, happy to feel that.
At the end of the line, of the line.
And it don't matter if you're by my side.
At the end of the line,
I'm satisfied.
Well, it's all right, even if you're old and gray. Well, it's all right, you still got something to say. Well, it's all right, remember to live.
think that Tom Petty would have been a hit without the Heartbreakers?
I don't think so.
How come?
I mean, he may have been, but, you know, Mike Campbell is one of the finest guitar players in the world. And Ben Montench, so underrated, like Mike Campbell as a piano player. Stan Lynch was just one of the greatest drummers and writers. And harmony, he really had the harmonies down for Tom. And Ron Blair was like the bass player who just kept the beat. But that band is like no other that I've ever seen in my life. He could have been. People also ask me, what would have happened if you hadn't accidentally picked up that record? And the answer is, I don't know. He could have been, he's going to be dropped from the label. He could have gone back to Gainesville and said, screw it. Band could have broken up, or he could have been signed by another label. Surely possible. No, it was a band, and, you know, every piece of that band glued the whole thing together.
Yeah. It's the Decibel Diaries on ZLX, and I'm Carter. Jon Scott, record company promo man, is the one who resurrected Tom Petty's first album from his record label Scrap Heap. That story is a legendary one in music business circles. But Jon also became a close friend of Tom Petty's, and they did much together throughout their lives. The stories are found in his book, Tom Petty and Me. You saw all the tours, and you worked for Tom for many years. Do you have a favorite tour?
The first one, after I had met Tom and he threw me out of the whiskey, then a week later, he called me up and wanted me to come over to his house. And at that moment, we bonded, and he said, hey, would you like to go on tour with us? I said, hell yeah. And so I got on the bus, and it was strictly a no-nonsense bus. It was just the guys, you know, nobody else allowed. And I saw him the first night in Santa Cruz, California, at a little auditorium or gymnasium. It was packed. And I saw him do six encores. Jeez. And people were wanting more. They kept clapping for more. And I went backstage and I said, Tom, they still want more. He said, John, we don't know any more songs. And at that minute, I've never seen in my life a band do six encores. I don't care if it's small place, big place. You know, just never seen it before.
Yeah,
you know, maybe Bruce, you know, but...
Yeah, I've seen Jay Giles do nine, but that's, you know, it's a short list.
The other tour that I just will never forget was the low-dough frequency tour that we did, because we were having trouble getting Tom exposed to the public, and we had to play for, if you were 103 on the dial, the tickets were $1.03.
Yeah.
And we knew that if the fans got in there, and the DJs especially, they'd come out fans. And that's exactly what happened. We played about 10 or 20 of those shows for $1.03, $1.04. And that's one of the things that just broke Tom Petty wide open, because every DJ that came out of the concert, like I said, were instant fans, and they were playing Tom Petty the next day.
Yeah, yeah. Jon Scott, his new book, Tom Petty and Me, I got to recommend it. It's such a fun read. I had some questions about the end, but I'm not going to talk about the end, because I like to remember Tom Petty at the beginning, and we've got the music, so he'll be living with us forever. And thanks for writing this book, man.
Well, thank you, Carter, for taking the time to talk to me, because you're right, Tom, his music will live on forever and ever. It's generational. I get so many people who go to TomPettyMe.com. And they say, dedicate this book to my dad who turned me on to Tom Petty when I was 11. It'll be here long, long time, man. It's just going to keep going and going. It'll never stop. He was the most iconic rock and roll star and writer, songwriter in the world.
Yeah. I can't think of what it would be like if that unmarked record hadn't fallen out of the closet on you.
Right. Unbelievable how things like that happen. And I look at it as it was meant to be by a higher power.
What you're saying is God is a Tom Petty fan.
He is, man. There's no doubt about it.
All right.
Okay, great. It's TomPettyandMe.com. And I got a 2-for-1 special going on right now. So
2-for-1.
Okay, Carter.
All right, John.
He's hung out with the legends of classic rock. Now you can, too. It's Carter Allen's Decibel Diaries on 100.7 WZLX.
Jon Scott talking about the life and times of his good buddy. Pick up John's Tom Petty and Me. It's a fact-filled and a fun story of the early days of one of America's great music talents. You can get information or order yourself a copy at TomPettyandMe.com. I read it. I recommend it. All right. In classic rock, it has always been a no-brainer that Black Lives Matter. I mean, the whole genre was built on American blues and jazz, two art forms begun and nurtured by Black artists. Up next, I'm down with Living Color on the Decibel Diaries.